Hello, welcome to aonlinetraining.com. Now I'm teaching to design a web page layout in Adobe Animate CC, as well as the same process in Adobe Flash Professional. So let's have a look. I just want to show you what I'm making in web page layout. So for that, you need to be related files also, related contents. Okay, so I go to in file. Import stage. If all the items you want to import, all the comes on the stage. Otherwise, you keep it in library. So I'll just keep it in import to library. Now, what I want to be select my images text. So I have select all the images by using a shift and then open. Okay, so I just replace or do not replace that. Now for library, you can go window. There is a library. Yeah, this is a library or control app. These are the contents which I have to be using here, making a web page layout. So this is what I'm going to design as a web page. So this is just for reference for you guys. Okay, so you get have a look to understand what I'm making from here. Actually, web page is divided into three parts. The first is top panel. Second is your banners, where you keep a banners and then thirds for your contents. Okay, the content you can fix your bottom page, that you can as a footer. Okay, in that you can show the links of contact. Okay, this is what that. Now, for the web page layout, as I told that this is divided into three or four parts, so I have taken into in each layers. Okay, it easy to select, keep a selection on that, log, hide. So don't make it in single layers, you always to keep in separate layers, and the most thing you have to be keep the layers name. So I have just keep my layers name is header or top. Then I have to be use either you can use primitive or either you can shape, but I used to be a shape. This is a more convenient for me. Then I selection, I have just delete the outline and use the free transform tool, or just transform on the edge of my stage. Now I just you can just take any size of your web page layout. I keep 900 by 1290. You can use any of the size. By default is 800 by 600. I'll just keep 1290. So keep it this one. Then I have easily to, you know, subtract, easily to select. So that's why it's a usual value. Now, from this, I'll just delete this. Now for transform, what I do, I'll just use this registration point to be top, and I just zoom on first with control plus, just zoom it on. Okay, then it's easy to divide. Then I just take this one, Or for margin, the better you can use, go to the view, rulers. You can use as the margin, like how many pixels, how much pixels you want, or what margin you want for the banners, the content, or the footer. That means inside you can use the contact or the links. Okay, this is easy to see how you can divide the things. Now I can use a selection tool and you can overlap my rectangle tool. This is easy to select. Then you can give color. What color? Just fix the colors. I'll just delete this out. Outline color you won't delete, just double click and go to the stroke and just delete the null. So just no need to be delete. If it really confusion to select, just double click and unlock the stroke color. Okay, just select and go to the next part. This is the other part. Just have this one. Now change the color. Second thing, I just want to be this should be white and this is gray. After that you can hide the ruler, find the grids or guides. Then this is my top. Then cut, edit, cut, make new layer. Name this. I can just go to paste in place. Double click. Banner. Then select this one, cut, make new layer, double click, strip, then paste in place, then select, cut, just new layer. Middle page or content. Select this as cut. I keep this bottom layer should be as bottom. Just drag it. Or I just git is footer. So top you can call foot header and the bottom you can footer. If I just log, nobody's selection. That's good. Now on which page I have worked, I have only to select this. So footer I don't want, top I don't want, middle I don't want, yeah, banner I want. So I select this banner. Let's see. Banner, I just go with banner. This banner. Now I go to my library, then I go my this model I just want. Now you have to remember that, see this image I go to in two of the layers background. I want to be on top of my layer, so this should be in which you have select. So I'll just keep any of the layers which is above of the banner. So I just select or just and cut it so I can paste into this here. Just lock my panel. And use for transform is Q shortcut or you can go for free transform. Or I just told you that change the registration point so it's easy to fix your transform, right? Then I have lock, I have select, unlock my banner. I'll just change a little bit over there. I'll just make some design over there. Now for the items, I just use, first of all, I just type some text. So yeah, this banner can, banner is locked, and banner, now I have worked on this content, so middle page, make the outer layer of the middle page, name is text, use a text tool, now text sum. Keep all the layers should be closed. Which you are working, that should only be unlocked. Go to properties, change the color. Which color you want? And go to the black and change the font. Which font do you like related to the fashion? Because I'm designing for the fashion Western clothes website. So according to that, I change my font. It look nice. I'm just guest selection. Yeah, I'll just keep this one. Okay, there's one thing I tell you, how I can just align this object or text into the center of the page. So window, there's an align bar, align to the page, and this is center horizontally, or this is what you call it, right? So this is how you can center align your objects. I keep my lines. Just alt. And select the lines and change origins. Now go to the library, and first I want this back. Yeah, I have to be just lock this layer and make the new layer. See, the background is white. It is okay, otherwise you can select the background transparent, or you can get the PNG image. It's come background transparent. I'll go my other object. Okay, I have to be import a file, import the library. There is another object. Okay, let's take any of them. Now I can make some borders. So just lock new layer, change the name. Change this outline color. I just want to change this outline color. I just put the black and the fill color should be done. Same thing, alt and drag, alt.
and just switch like this.
Then you can use the contents of the contacts. I just take some icons like Facebook. Now footer page is this, they cover. Transform. Just look out on 100% because 100% is actual view. So keep according to the 100% scale. And put text. Can use my rectangle shapes. Change the gradient. Change into break apart, select the outline, change the gradient. Select F8, it should be graphic. Just right click. If two objects are in same layer, you can just right click and arrange, send to back. Same thing you can use one lens. Right click, arrange, send back. Send back. Select to all, or you can just make the group. You have to be just few and even you can just go Control G also. So just Control G. So just make it center. Or you can use the help of alignment, windows and align. Align to the stage. Oh, let's go middle of my page. That's where it is. Okay. Another text is related to, suppose my, what's logo name is my fashion. That copyrights 2002. Then scale. Right. This is my page. It's great problem in scaling. Okay, no problem. I just reduce the size. Okay, you can add more things as you want. Now my buttons, I'll just take these buttons actually, all because buttons always look same if you use them in top or the bottom as header and footer. So I'll just make the copy with the alt. I'll just take out, just cut it, mark this and my top. Stitch here, make new and paste in place. Then with arrow, I take up. Right, it's come up. And I choose. I do ungroup, Control Shift G. Just select this. Now Control G and scale it. You always do scale with Shift because it's already constrainedly scaled. I will say you have to work on 100%. This is what actually, you know, show you. Control G for group, spacebar for panning the stage. Okay, just give a little bit more space. Right. Now, my logo. So finally I done my web page layout. So I hope you can understand how to design the web page layout in Flash or Adobe Animate CC. And please remember, you have to be always to be working separately as with proper names, so it's easy to hide, lock and easy to selection with that. For queries, please contact us on info@aonlinetraining.com. Have a nice day.